and dad, I'm doing fine. You guys are on my mind. You asked me what I wanted to be, and now I think the answer is plain to see. I wanna be famous. I wanna live close to the sun. Oh, pack your bags, cause I've already won. Everything to prove, nothing in my way. I'll get there one day.
Alright, before we properly start the episode, I just wanted to mention that I wanted to show you guys the reward that the streaming golfers have won. So before I get into the episode, I just wanted to show you guys what they actually have fought for besides safety. They also have earned themselves a little bit of a something something. So you can see here, there's like a lady standing there, and it's a pizza delivery lady. So they have earned themselves a full pizza to share together, so everybody can eat a slice. I'm gonna make them all grab something and just take we just gonna make them call to meal. Everybody grab a slice, enjoy yourselves. Hopefully y'all enjoy it. I made sure it's cheese pizza because you don't know if there's a vegetarian or if there's a vegan, I'm sorry, but I'm sure there's a vegetarian or something. We'll throw this away. Hopefully y'all enjoy your little pizza time. But after this, it's gonna go back to the competitions. And y'all know what it is, so we'll keep in the Big Brother. Not Big Brother. Wrong show! We'll keep in the Total Drama Island place right here. We're gonna stay with the Screaming Gophers, so I'm just gonna skip straight to the introduction of the episode. I already did the intro, so we'll just skip to the introduction. Alright guys, welcome to another episode of Total Drama Island Sims Edition. Let me just give you a quick recap of what happened last time. So last week in the Total Drama Island competition, we had a game and the Screaming Gophers won once more. And the Killer Bass had to go through another... Oh, what's going on with you? They got Poseidon's Kiss. Huh? Going back to what we were discussing, the last time the Killer Bass lost again, and they're not doing so well. Their streak is actually very bad. Well, the Screaming Gophers keep triumphing, they keep winning competitions, but the Killer Bass also have to get rid of another player, and they have decided to get rid of Noah. And that's basically about it. We're just gonna go back here. Oh, we also found out that Bridget and Lashana have an alliance. So that's pretty interesting. Oh my god, what is going down over here? I think they're arguing. No, they're not. Okay, they just don't. I don't know. Okay, they're having a nice conversation. Never mind. Forget what I was saying. It looked like they were arguing because Courtney is pissed. Alright, but we do have over here Bridget and Beth talking as well with Jeff and Gwen. Pretty interesting choice of characters, not gonna lie. Beth is actually doing God's work. She's talking to people that are not on her group and making friends with them as well. Although this could make her a target in this group of people on her own team. If they don't notice it, that she actually might be on the safer route. She's gonna go hopping on the hot tub. Everybody's having fun in the hot tub. Like I said, anybody's welcome, even if you're from the Killer Bass, like, you're welcome to join in, but the Screaming Gophers have to allow it. But, I did a little bit of an off-recorded, lookout on them. So, like, as, the game progressed a little bit, I did take a look after them a little bit, not recording it, just kind of paying attention a little bit, and I did notice something that surprised me, not gonna lie, and it's the fact that I think Courtney and Lindsay have an alliance that I was not ready for. Considering how their history in other games were like, yo, like, we don't get along that well because we're basically rivals. Lindsay and Courtney, for those who don't know, if you watch the show Total Drama Action, then you might know that they had an ongoing rivalry. Lindsay did not get along, well, Courtney did not get along with Lindsay, because Lindsay was getting lucky with her games. Courtney was throwing calculated and strategic remarks, while Lindsay was not even doing anything and she was getting away with a lot of things. But Lindsay did start to develop as a character as well. But yeah, Lindsay managed to become friends with Courtney, and Courtney with Lindsay, and it's a very unlikely alliance in my opinion. But you know what? This is the season of surprises. I feel like they could also be an alliance that could be information. Like, I feel like they might have some connections. Some of them woke up from their naps, so you can pay attention to their gameplay now. Cody's just playing with a soccer ball for him. Beth woke up. She's not talking to anybody. She's just having fun there. Duncan is talking to Izzy. That's cool. Where's CJ? DJ's in the hot tub too. Oh wait, no, that wasn't Duncan. That was Owen who was talking to Izzy. Wrong one. Sorry. Duncan's just chilling. DJ is just currently chilling as well. He's just enjoying the water, being himself. Izzy, yep, also having a good time. She's talking to Owen still. Oh, Lindsay and Gwen. Are they gonna get along? They did have an on and off relationship in Total Drama Island, because Lindsay was in an alliance with Heather. Heather did not get along with Gwen, but Gwen kind of understood that Lindsay was not exactly all there with Heather. In the sense of, like, Heather was basically using her, so she kind of picked up on that. But yeah, I feel like Gwen and Lindsay could make some good friends if they gave themselves the benefit of the doubt and they worked it out. Lindsay's not a person to have any sort of anger towards anybody, except for maybe Heather. But I feel like even for Heather, she might be a little bit apologetic. Courtney is pissed. Is this gonna last forever? No, just for 4 hours. Okay. Courtney's not happy. What are you not happy about? She is not getting along with LaShawna at all. She despises LaShawna. She.
Sam's a queen.
Ginger. Laugh. We dog. Kachun. She was. It's Pinaru. Baloof.
Is Trent going along with it? She's not getting along with. She's okay-ish with Trent, but she's having an argument with LaShawna. What? Courtney. What are you doing? Stomp on what? Is there trash on the floor again? Yes, there is. She is pissed. She does not like LaShawna. Courtney, that is not the way that you're supposed to play the game. You're gonna step on glass. Whatever. Anyway. Keep looking at these people. What is Owen doing? Relaxing? Okay. Still talking to Ify. So I'm sure that maybe the Ify and Owen ship is happening still. Maybe they're still getting along a little bit, but they're not having the best conversation either. Which is very Ify-like, honestly. Ify's very on and off with Owen. So who knows, maybe the Owen and Izzy relationship continues on as time passes by. It all really depends. Again, the only alliance that I can really think of this group would be Lindsay and Courtney. I don't see anybody else having a stronger alliance. Maybe Owen and Izzy could be having something. They have been talking a lot together. It seems like Courtney only gets along with a group amount of people, which is not good for her gameplay. That could put a damper on her game. She does not want to make enemies in the house, and if she does, she's going to lose, and she's going to lose big time. Especially since there's going to be a jury in this game as well. So she might want to keep an eye out for that. That being said, I'm going to cut it right here. We're just going to skip to the killer bass and check them out, and just we'll leave the Screaming Gophers be for now. I will see you guys then. Alright, we're hanging with the Killer Bats now, and we're just gonna check them out and see how they're doing. As I promised, this team has not been doing so well. But here we are. We're just gonna do a shorter version of what I was gonna do with them, because the compass is gonna be a little bit long, I believe. So we'll just do our best here. Who the fuck are you? Uh oh, we're just not feeling good. Just nauseous. Ah, not anymore. She's fine. She held it in like a champ.
But here to reach. Funobe. Weasel Fraba. A Bode Quar.
Alright, we got Lashana having a conversation with Alejandro and Duncan. They seem to be having a nice conversation, despite them not being all that friendly. I mean, Lashana does kind of appreciate Duncan and knows the side of Duncan that not a lot of people do know of him. While with Alejandro, it's kind of unlikely that she actually has a relationship with Alejandro, but this might just be a ploy against him maybe in the future. Maybe they're working together, we don't know just yet. All we know is that Lashana's definitely paired up with Bridget. They're definitely gonna be working together, I can tell. So, yeah, I think that I can just make that alliance official. Lashana and Bridget being an alliance. And I think it's a very unlikely but very wholesome alliance. I believe it's a very nice alliance idea. And he's all the way over there. Jeff, go back home, bitch. He's still playing with that ball. Just there. Trying to join again in the conversation with Gwen and Bridget.
And Fabi Frenoy.
Hopefully they get along. At least Bridget seems to be getting along with a lot of the campers right here on this side. So that's good for her. That's actually good that she actually has some alliances. However, they already lost two competitions. And they lost two contestants. That's not good for them. They need to pull their weight, and they actually need to pull in some strength into the competition. If they lose another one, they just might even give it to the Screaming Gophers, honestly. So they might need to pull through in the competition if they want to win. Because they just might be in deep water, like, due to poor competition. But hopefully, they pull through. They have this one more shot. They still got more shots, but they got one more shot to at least try to even it out against the Screaming Gophers, because they need this right now on their favor. They already lost two contestants, and the Screaming Gophers are still intact. So hopefully they keep their numbers in the competition strong. They just seem to be having a normal conversation, though. They're not really going to get into that like that. But, yeah. At least they're getting along with the Screaming Gophers as well. That's actually pretty smart to keep the relationship that way. So, hopefully they keep it that way. Lashana is still with Owen. Actually, no, hold up. Lashana's just playing with Owen. She might go take a nap, that's fine. Is Jeff still over there? Yes, he is. Jeff! Are you okay? You need a shower. Is he okay? Ever since I got here, he's been here the whole time. I can't make decisions for him. He has to make these decisions for himself. Are you gonna go and do something? No? Gwen and Duncan are having a moment right now. Courtney is probably ignoring that. Oh, she's gonna talk to Beth now. Alright, since I already did spend a lot of time with the Screaming Gophers, I think I'm just gonna cut it here for the Killer Bath and make it a little bit short. Hopefully, I'm just gonna let them do their thing. I'm gonna keep an eye out on them. And they just seem to be having a nice thing together, honestly. Just a quick recap of what I think is gonna go down. Bridget and Lashana are definitely working together. They might have a third alliance member, but I can't confirm that just yet. I will confirm it once I see it one more time. But in the meantime, I must add that I feel like some characters here are in danger compared to other ones from the Screaming Gophers. I believe that in the Screaming Gophers, Cody is not in the safer route. Maybe even Iffy is not in the safer route, as well as on the Killer Bass. I think that Gwen is not really pulling her weight all that much. And looking at Jeff, who hasn't even left this area at all, even if he looks like that, has not even left this area, which I don't know if he's glitched. I hope he's not. He doesn't want to go home. He just keeps doing the same things over and over. But, oh, well, I don't get to decide that for him. He'll eventually figure it out. All right, guys, but I'm going to leave it at that. We're going to see you guys at the competition because it's going to be a little bit of a while for it. And I'll see you guys then. All right, everybody, this is the competition for the week. So we are going to do darts. We're going to do a darts challenge, but the way that it's going to work is that they're going to be playing darts against their other team. However, I had to select a couple of characters at random to not participate. Those characters are going to be Cody and Duncan, since this needs to be an even out kind of a game. So Cody and Duncan will not be participating in this challenge. Anybody else can participate for their team. That being said, we're gonna let them off play this competition. I already have them pre-selected randomly as well, so there's gonna be like one person from one team versus one person from the other team, and they're gonna go head to head on a darts competition. To give you an example, we're gonna start it off with Trent. So Trent, I want you to play a darts game against Beth right now. So you and Beth, we get to play darts. Beth will be representing the Screaming Gophers, as Trent will be representing the Killer Bass. So whoever wins the competition, we will know by their actions, will actually be giving a point to their team. The one who wins best out of 6 games, I believe. So best 4 out of 6, basically. Trent's doing pretty good. So good job, Trent. You're doing pretty good for your team right now. We'll see how they... Ooh, Bev! Bev's doing splendid. So we will be able to know by their actions what who's going to win the competition. So... I will be sure to keep an eye out for which team wins for who. Alrighty, looks like Trent has won a point for the Killer Bass. Congratulations, Trent, you actually won them a point. Bev, I'm sorry, that does mean that you are not giving a point to your team, but that doesn't mean that all is lost. Up next, we're gonna go head to head with Bridget versus Izzy. So we're gonna put Izzy and Bridget together in a match. Best of luck to both of you. Good luck. May the best one win. Looks like Izzy is our winner. We have the score right there. Izzy has won it for the Screaming Gophers. Congratulations, Izzy. You gained yourself a point. Sorry, Bridget, that does mean that you do not win a point for the Killer Bass. Right now, it's actually tied. Congratulations, Izzy. You've done great. Ladies, please take a seat. Last but not least, we're gonna move on to our last two competitors, Gwen versus Courtney. You two will be playing head-to-head as well. You guys will be giving yourself a speed advantage. Well, not a speed advantage, but like, you're giving yourself an advantage winning this competition. So whoever wins it, you might be lucky for this. And this is only the first round, so I'm just gonna let y'all play this because we still have 3 more rounds to cover. So good luck to all of you. All right, so really quick recap, this is the reason why I actually also write down who won certain competitions or who did certain things. I always have this recorded on, like, I have these written down, I have them saved. I never forget to do this, and I do it for this very reason. I lost the footage of this part of the competition where Courtney actually beat Gwen. So, spoiler, Courtney actually won that part of the competition, so it's 2 points for the Screaming Gophers and 1 point so far for the Killer Bass. But we're going to leave it at that so that way we can skip over to the rest of the game and you guys can see it for yourself. So sorry for this inconvenience, but I wanted to let you guys know that Courtney was actually the winner of this competition. That being said, I'll see you guys in the rest of the competition. Thank you for understanding. I apologize.
All right, campers, same rules apply. Lashana, you will be playing for the Killer Bass, and Owen for the Screaming Gophers. You guys are up next. Good luck to both of you. For references, we do have 2 points in favor of the Screaming Gopher and 1 point in favor of the Killer Bass. So if Lashana wins this, we're tied. Oh, wow. Jonathan's doing some good points. But if the Screaming Gophers win, they will be one game ahead of winning the whole thing for their team and winning a movie for their team. So best of luck. Wow, they're killing it. Ooh, that's going to be a tough one. Good luck to both of you. And Lashana wins it for the Killer Bass. That means they are currently tied. Lashana, congratulations on winning a point for the Killer Bass. Owen, I'm so sorry. That does mean that you do not give it for the Screaming Gophers, but that is okay because they're still up there with the Killer Bass. Lindsay could carry the game and Alejandro, DJ as well for the Screaming Gophers, but it could also go for Jeff and Alejandro. So speaking of Jeff, we're going to be playing with him next. You two can take a seat. Jeff, you will be playing against Lindsay from the Screaming Gophers. Good luck to the both of you. Best of luck. Oh, they're not playing. Do it again. Fine. Alright, so it's currently tied. You guys could be the tiebreaker, and Alejandro and DJ can play it off next. Good luck to the both of you. I believe in you guys. You guys can do it for your teams. Best of luck. Congratulations, Jeff! That means that you give another point to the Killer Bass. Congratulations. You will be giving your team a secure spot. You might not be completely safe just yet. Sorry, Lindsay, that does mean that you do not give a point to the Screaming Gophers. This will all fall on Alejandro's hands right now if they want to guarantee safety for the Killer Bass for the first time in this competition. DJ, if you win this competition, you tie it, and we're gonna select two people at random to break the tie off. With that being said, we will leave these two together and see how it goes. Alejandro, this all falls on you. Do your best for your team if you want the Killer Bass to be safe. DJ, if you want your team also to remain the way that it is, I suggest you do the same, make it consider a tie. So good luck to the both of you. This could be the end game. We will see. Yeah. That means, yep, it's official. The Killer Bass has finally won immunity for the first time. Congratulations, Alejandro. You have won it for your team. You guys are finally safe, and you get to keep your team the way that it is right now. Congratulations. You finally did it for your team. You guys actually got away with it this time. I am sorry for the Screaming Gophers. You guys are finally gonna have to get rid of someone for elimination. So I apologize that you guys have lost, but this is a first for you guys. I am sorry. Congratulations, Alejandro and the Killer Bass. You guys have won immunity and a prize as well that I will reveal in the next episode. So congratulations to you guys. You guys have earned it.
I will see you guys later. We're going to meet with the Screaming Gophers right now so we can deliberate their decision on who they want to get rid of. That being said, y'all, I will see you guys at the Screaming Gophers camp to so you guys can discuss a little bit on who you guys want to evict, or in this case, eliminate. So I will see you guys at the campsite and then at the campfire ceremony. All right, campers. We're here at the campfire ceremony. The reason that you guys are here is because you didn't do that well in the last competition, and the killer bats won immunity. That means one of you has to go home due to a selection by the group, and that will mean that you can never come back. Ever. But that's only one of you. So, we're gonna start off by saying the group of people that I think are safe. Well, I don't think I don't think they're safe. I know they're safe because I just calculated who is leaving the competition. We're gonna start off with the first person that is safe. That person is DJ. You get to select a marshmallow. Also, yes, please add a log there. It's dying. The next person we'd call is also safe. That person is Beth. Congratulations, Beth. Huh? The next person I will call is Lindsay. Congratulations, Lindsay, you are safe. The next name I will be calling is Duncan. Could you please come on up and receive your marshmallow? The next person I will be calling is Cody, you are safe. Oh. The next person I will call is
Ben and Robbie.
Courtney. Ah. Campers, this is our final marshmallow. Congratulations, Owen. You are safe. That does mean, Izzy, you are our third evicted character on the island, and our first Screaming Gopher eliminated. Not evicted, this is not my brother. My brother's stuck. That means that you must walk the Dock of Shame. So, Izzy, you've played an interesting game. Congratulations on your progress. You made it this far. You won two competitions. It seemed like you guys were just going to take the whole thing. But alas, you are not one to celebrate with them. So I'm sorry, but you have been eliminated from the competition. It was nice having you in the Total Drama Island cast. As for the rest of you, you guys are safe for now. Congratulations on not being eliminated tonight. You guys can continue to compete in the next challenges and still have a shot at winning the whole thing. That being said, we will leave you guys at that. Guys, we're going to pause right there. I just want to say thank you guys for the support, for supporting this little thing that I just keep making, like these little competitions that I like making just for fun. It's always fun to do them. I always have fun making them. And I just can't wait to do more of these in the future. I'm sure of it. it's just gonna be something fun for me to do. It keeps me off from like literally just stuff around the world, and it's just like stuff that I like to do here. But guys, thank you so much for supporting this and watching, for staying till the end of this episode, and for making it for this long, honestly. But that's it for tonight. For today, thank you so much for watching this. I love you guys so much. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good night, and take care.